Hello, little piggy. Who is running in the wrong direction to save their life? Who's running into a dead end?
Greetings, guys and girls and fellow gamers. My name is Games for Kicks, and welcome back to Modded Days to Die, where we play 7 Days to Die modded using Valmod. In the last episode, we started working on our tunnel that's gonna go underneath our house, but we're gonna be working today on our farm, which looks remarkably like an aqueduct. And some people have said it in the comments as well. Anyway, either way, I hope you're gonna enjoy the episode today. If you do, remember to kick that like button in the balls to support the channel and the series. And if you're new to the channel and you like what you see, hit that subscribe button. So let's get started. Now, a couple of things have happened since the last episode. I'm gonna go through them in a second. I just want to finish upgrading my pickaxes. Another one should be ready now. Come on. And that would have been, I think, 7 or 8 pickaxes, or in total 10 even, since I started grinding last night, which is great. There we go. Nice. Awesome. Awesome-tastic. So now we're just making some cobblestone rocks, and we're going to prepare working on the farm. Now, since the last episode, I made a little hole there that I started preparing, and that is for us to test something out in a little while. Is that an apple tree over there? Oh, it looked like it. Anyway. We're working on the farm as well. Now, the upgrade of pickups is required because we need to work faster down in our tunnel, and stone is so slow to destroy. So what I actually spent most of my points on was crafting, the fast crafting or quicker crafting. That's what I spent 20 points on, and that helped actually a lot. And the next thing I'm going to focus on after that is also Miner 69er. I think we can actually get more into that. Miner 69er, yep, mining tools as soon as they're 60. We're going to take that, which is going to take a little while, but hey-ho, I'm going to spend my points on quicker crafting first, because that will help a lot. Now, the next thing we're going to work on is this part here on the farm, where we are going to basically put opposite sides these blocks. And I messed that up on this one, so that's why this one has to come down, actually. There we go. Because I made this one the wrong way around. This one here has to go to the inside, but the other one is on the outside, so there was basically a gap, which is not nice. Anyway, I'm going to start working on this, and what I would like to do is actually then afterwards on the other side, or maybe even in the middle, have like a stream of wood. That would be awesome, actually. If we do 2 on each side, and then have them 5 across, and then the middle one has water going across. Oh, that would be awesome. I don't know if weight-wise we can actually carry that. Let me actually see. So how much weight can... This can't carry much weight. Max load of 24, mass 4. So I'm assuming a cobblestone frame plate could do the same in ratio. That would be pretty awesome, because then we could actually make this look really, really nice. Oh man, yeah, we have to try that. Would be lovely to get some water going in there as well. And here we go. Let's see if this will hold everything. Okay, so far so good. Now the test comes when we actually have them upgraded all. So the first ones we should probably upgrade is the ones on the side that are holding everything. So we should probably upgrade these guys first. Nice. And then these guys. And now that we can get water from the tap, I wonder if you could fill up a bucket on it as well. That would be pretty boss. So I don't think we have enough stone. We're gonna have to go on a big stone grind. But that's all the reason. I think if I would start this game again, that's exactly what I would do. I would get quick crafting up as soon as possible, and then craft non-stop tools and get them upgraded on the workbench. Nice. I like it. Oh, no! Okay, so much for the weight. Ha! Damn it. So it won't be able to carry the weight. We might have to put wood plates underneath. So maybe we can put between these guys, the wood plate versions, maybe. okay, the only way to solve this problem with the poles is basically finding something that can carry more weight. Now, one of the things that can carry a lot of weight is, and I actually found that by chance now, is when I looked at poles, because I obviously need to make a pole, is obviously the concrete pole is going to be able to hold a lot of weight. Anything to do with scrap will be able to hold a lot of weight. But I also want it to look good, so I don't want to put scrap blocks on top of these, yeah? But we need to replace the top parts of the poles with something else. So the only pole that can hold a lot of weight is the chain link pole. I crafted one of those and just tried it, but it looks really ugly. The chain link pole can hold up to 320 weight, which means if I replace these top two poles with chain link poles, it will definitely be able to carry everything in between, but the problem is they're so thin, it actually looks really, really ugly. So the only way of really getting to sort this out is by making these concrete, which means we need to get a concrete mix. We need to get an engine, guys. So I'm gonna need to go chop some cars. It's gonna be a bit of a cut now, because I definitely want to do that in this episode. So let's go back into the city, or into the other place. I think there was cars over there, and this is less dangerous. Let's go back to the village and see if there's any more cars, and we're gonna take them all apart and loot nothing else except the cars, and hopefully we get an engine. Before we go to town though, I'm gonna have to get a little bit more iron, because I have no more arrows left, and I don't want to make my iron arrows. A few of you guys in the comments have mentioned crossbows, and I didn't realize I can already make a crossbow, which is absolutely awesome. So to make the iron crossbow, I need some forged iron. The problem is that I'm out of iron in the moment because of all the pickaxe heads that I made. And I made some forged iron, but it's not enough. So we're gonna be doing a little bit of this. And I'm gonna go make one or two crossbow, iron crossbows. And I have already the iron arrow heads made up. I just, literally, as I was about to craft the iron arrows, I remembered you guys saying about the crossbow. So, and seeing that I can make it, it will be iron crossbow arrows instead.
Hello, little piggy. Who is running in the wrong direction to save their life? Who's running into a dead end?
Okay, this might be harder than I thought. There's some zombies here, which I haven't got a clue what they are. So let's loot them and see. Oh, nice! Nice, okay, let's see if we can do a couple of more headshots with that. Ah, shit. Oh, this guy is dangerous, he spits fire. Nice. Let's loot this guy. Nice! They're all together, I really wish I would have a barrel or something to blow them up with. Come on. Oh, shit. Woo-hoo-hoo, balls, balls, balls. This guy is tough. Okay, so you know what? Screw that. I'm just gonna run and take the car apart. And we hope for the best. Let's just do that. Running, running, running. And we're out of liquid as well. We're out of drinks. Balls. It will take them a while to get to me, so let's hope we can take the car apart for until then. Come on. One engine is enough. One engine is all we need. Okay, there's more cars over there. We need the gun in case we get to dogs. Zombies we probably can deal with. Dogs is what we worry about. Okay, great. Oh, man. Did we not get an engine yet? Oh, we did! Oh, yes! Okay, screw that. I'm back out of here. I didn't even realize we got an engine. Let's not die, because then I lose everything. Okay, come on. There's loads of zombies. Okay, let's get out of here. We got one engine. That's enough. Okay, let's get out. Whew, man, look at how many those. Oh man, look how many they are. Whoa, that is insane. Holy balls. We're gonna have to come back here with like several bullets of shotguns or something. Anyway, I'm gonna keep running. I'm gonna keep going this way. We have no drink, so our stamina is gonna go down really rapidly. And I don't think there was any drink in the loot, was there? No. All right, okay. I'm gonna go back home. Screw that. So while the cement mixer is crafting and we get ourselves back into a normal state, I'm gonna work on this here, or continue working on this. What this is about is basically I wanna test this little trap. These pieces of earth. So I don't know what they're... They have a max load of 10 and a mass of 1, so I just wanna make a little square and see how it works. So that's really all I'm interested in making a very tiny 3x3 hole. To see how that goes. To dig down here, yeah, okay. 3x3 is very hard to see because I always end up digging more than or too far in. I think this one here, yeah. I brought some, well, I didn't bring any blocks, balls. Let me see. One, two, yeah, I see. Ah. Okay, so these two I have to still get out. Nice and excellent. Okay, for test purposes, I think this is... Is that deep enough? Oh, we make it one more. We make it one more. Go one more round. There we go. And then we're gonna cover it up with the fake earth, and we're probably gonna test it out ourselves as well. I mean, I made enough of them, so we should be able to see if it works. And this is just for testing, really, so... Come on, pick up. Nice. Okay. Let's put the fake fall trap earth down. I wonder if it collapses with me as well. So you walk over, you go here. Woo! Look at that! It actually collapses. That is awesome. That is nice. I like it. So let's get back out. Come on. There we go. Nice. And let's close this off again. So this is our little fall trap. Let's see if we catch anything. Now, nothing will happen, obviously. If they fall down there, they're just gonna be stuck. But this is pretty cool. I like that because it looks so natural. Look at this. That is so cool. And zombie will walk over it and then go clonk. Oh, balls. Now, we're gonna have to make this very deep and a little bit across. It would be great to have this all the way around. That would be nice. So, our cement mixer should be finished now. Yes. Oh, sweet. Where are we gonna put it? Well, here's where we're gonna fight the zombies. I don't really want too much on that side, so let's put it over here. Excellent. So can we still get in and out from here? So if I go up here... Yeah, we still can manage. That's okay. Sweet! Now we can make finally some cement. I have to make a chisel, then we're gonna have to make some cement concrete poles, and then we can finally finish or start working properly on our farm. I'm actually being an absolute idiot. I did not even cop on to that. If you look at what you need to make concrete poles, okay? Oh, I'm such an idiot. I didn't even need... Oh, concrete poles. Okay, you can only make them in there. So we needed it after all. Because I was just looking at concrete mix. And I was like, yeah, but concrete mix I can make in my inventory. All I need is cement and, you know, so... If you look at this, I can make it in my inventory. But yeah, of course, for the poles, we need the machine. So yeah, I'm gonna burn some stone now here. So we make some cement. We get some concrete mix going. And I have to look for sand. Where do I find sand? Oh, this whole thing should be full of sand here. The whole path... should be full of sand. The gravel paths, wherever we have gravel paths, it should be working enough. I don't think we have a gravel path going up to this house. It's a bit of a shame. No, we don't. Ah, damn it. But there's these gravel holes everywhere, so we're going to start digging actually into one of them. Gravel patches, and maybe we even find a source of iron. Who knows? These guys, let's just start digging here, because that is exactly what they're for. Sweet. This actually levels up your masonry as well. Pretty cool. Look at this. One done. Then you go over to the next one, where you have slightly set it apart in time. Boom, next one. And then you wait for this one again. And that actually levels up your masonry, which is pretty cool. So we're at 65 now. And now the next one should pop in. There we go. And we just leveled masonry to 65. So let's see how quickly we're going to get to 66. Here we go. Here's the next one. Let's actually see how quick our masonry goes up. Masonry. If I could spell it. It's actually halfway through. There we go. Just caught that one on the tail end. And look at that. That is nice. I'm going to keep doing that. Level up the masonry. Then get some concrete poles done. And then we're going to continue work. Okay, we're just going to upgrade these guys. This is the last ones. Nice. Okay. Sweet, this one is already dry. We're gonna have to wait for them to dry. And I think maybe we don't need to wait for them to dry. We'll see. Let's see if we can put these guys across. What is it? The cobblestone frames, yes. This is a bit far away. I don't think this will reach. We're going to have to come from the other side. We're going to have to nerf pole up. Let me see, we want to go here. No, we want to go here. Excellent. Okay, so at least this is holding, which is good. Lovely. And it's after we upgraded them that we had the problems. So we definitely want to wait until everything is dried before we upgrade these guys. Look what we found. Let's see if that works, that little trap. Damn it, we're not fast enough. Okay, we have to shoot him once. Now come on. Walk across. Walk across the stupid trap. Don't be so intelligent. Okay, we're gonna have to do that differently. We're gonna have to jump over the trap. Okay, so let's go, and... Ah, oh, come on! What good is a fall trap if he just runs over? That is stupid. Okay, fall trap pointless unless it's... Because it can just run over. Even if you make it, like, very, very long, it doesn't really matter. Because they just keep walking, and then it keeps collapsing behind them. Ah, I don't like that. Anyway, it was worth a try. Ah, well. Ah. Anyway, this over here doesn't work either. It's the frames itself in the middle. They just cannot support the weight. So even though these guys can carry a lot, it's the actual frames themselves in between that can't. So we're going to have to think of something else. I don't know, I'm probably going to have to come up with either a brick plate, or I think what will definitely work, and might look actually quite good as well, is they have, what are they called? These guys here, the metal plates. So they should carry a lot, and we can make them green or blue. So let's make them blue, because I think blue is nice, especially if we can make the middle one blue and the other one's green. Yeah, that's a good choice. Let's see if they can carry all the weight. Now, these guys should be able to carry the weight now. So we have a blue metal plate, which has a max load of 320 and a mass of 20. So, which means they are exactly like concrete in that case, or even reinforced concrete or whatever, which means we should be able to easily put these guys beside each other. And they should be able to carry each other's weight. Absolutely. So let's just put this guy here. Because as soon as I put the last frame the last cobblestone frame up, everything started collapsing. So we put the metal plates up for the outside. There we go. Nice. Okay, so that's these guys. Then we have this side. Nice. Oh, okay, and the middle one is gray. Oh yeah, I forgot the other one. So I need a little bit more green. This seems to take forever, guys, because the cement is just not drying. This one is finally dry now, but this one isn't. So it has to do with the sun, I'm sure. So I upgraded instead. These guys already built these poles up, upgraded them. And that should prepare as well for next time to actually finish this. So sorry about this, that this wasn't as much about farming as I wanted it to be. We had to go and make the concrete mix. I didn't realize that the cobblestone poles are not able to carry enough weight, so we had to upgrade them. There wasn't really much choice. And I'm glad we've actually played around with this and found some materials to carry the earth or carry everything. And in the middle have a nice water feature. That would be pretty awesome. But we're not going to be able to finish it this time around. So sorry about that. I hope you're going to enjoy the episode anyway. If you did, remember to kick that like button in the balls. And I hope I see you guys in another episode. And if you're new to the channel and you like what you see, hit that subscribe button. And I'll see you guys next time. Until then, as always, viel Spaß and happy gaming. This didn't go too well. Everything collapsed, so we had to put some pillars here, a pillar there, basically pillars everywhere in between, and then use the full blocks because otherwise we have the big gaps above the pillars, which looks absolute crap. But the good news is we have a pond right there, which allowed us to get some water and test out what this looks like with water. So we put some earth down. There we go. And now we can till it, which is great. Oh, whoops. This is looking lovely. And let's see what the first thing is we're gonna do. Now, we have some packets of seeds. So let's see what the seeds are. Grapes. Wow. Okay, make one grape seed. Make one hop seed. Stop making earth. And a wheat seed. That's exciting. Let's have these three different types of seeds first placed. Look at that. Awesome. This is nice. Man, I like the way this looks. Ooh, whoops. This is pretty cool. I like it.